Take a look at this house on 900 Sam Snead Loop. It's a really nice place, nestled back in the trees like that. Lots of pavement for parking, fenced yard, birch trees. We'll take a look around this place and then go look inside. Check out the swing hanging between the birches. Isn't that great? We'll go inside pretty soon, but there's the entryway. Kind of nestled back behind the trees. Can't really see it from the street, but there's a fenced front yard. Got a fenced backyard too. You can see back here is a good spot to park a trailer or RV. Fenced yard. You can open it up, drive an RV through, and there's also a fence to walk through or a gate to walk through there. I have to check out this backyard. Very, very nice. It's all fenced in. Terraced. Landscaped. Taking this picture on June 6th, so the plants haven't grown up yet, but you can imagine how beautiful that is there. It's all full of plants. More of the lawn. Go take a look at this shed here. Okay, this isn't your normal shed. Everything from the metal door to the way the whole place is built. Very well built shed. And from here you can easily see the back deck. Quiet spot. This kind of escape. Another little swing back there. Rhubarb. Other plants getting ready to come up. Okay, we're going to go take a look in through the double doors, but look at that covered entry porch. Skylights up here. Okay, I've just come inside and you need to see it in here. This is a great room. Just gorgeous. Just absolutely gorgeous. You can see all the way around, lots and lots of natural light all through it. There's a kitchen over there. And there are the double doors I just walked in. Notice the vaulted ceiling. We'll take another look at the kitchen here. As we go into the kitchen, you can see there's a work desk right there with a window above, a couple windows above that give lighting. Very nice kitchen. Quality cabinetry. Good sized breakfast bar. Look at the counter space in this kitchen. Plenty of it. There's the pantry just off the kitchen. Got it wide open, but you can shut this completely up. And you'd never know what was behind it. Over on this end, we have the laundry room. Garage is right out that door, but we'll take a look at that in a minute. Let's go out and take a look at this living room. This is a gas fireplace with a remote switch. So that's handy. And we'll go take a look down at the bedrooms. Down the hall, we have three bedrooms. Here's the first one on the left. Decent sized bedroom, currently being used as an office, but it is a bedroom with a closet. Across the hall is the bath. Full bathroom with a tile tub surround. And the second bedroom down here, a little bit larger. It's got windows in two sides of this bedroom. Closet and the master bedroom. And notice again the lighting there above the closet and above that window. So there are a closet on this side, a closet over there, the bathroom. Another full bath. Where the tile tubs around. Okay, we'll head right on in, but just before we do, I want you to notice this house is fully gutted. In a lot of ways, this house is better than new. It's been upgraded to the hilt. So let's take a look at this garage. Real nice garage. Workbench in the back. Shelving. Good spot for a freezer. That's the door that goes in the house. And check this out in the garage here. Alright. Is that handy or what? So you have a man door over there. And you have a man door that goes out back. Oh, I forgot to talk about this. That's Strawberry Hill. Strawberries are already coming up. They're already in bloom. So whoever buys this house is going to inherit strawberries ready to pick.